प्रज्ञालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमव्याप्तदेहाय लक्ष्मीनामूर्तये नमः सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तुमा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति 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 ब्रह्माण्डजातिगुरुं वेदादिश्च प्रणतस्मितुं बुद्धिप्रकाशं मुक्षुर्वै शरणं श्रीचिद्घनगणेशानुमोहमयं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपाधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेः दर्शितं सर्वेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्युत्तरं तदेव अन्नमत्वन्येति निश्चितामतिः being used in the four Mahavakyas. We saw the four Mahavakyas in the Mula. Now coming back to the Tippana. Yeah, the Tippana we have seen. Idancha Tattvamasi iti Vakyam in the analysis of Tattvamasi Mahavakya. The Pada, Tat and Tvam have three Sambandhas. So Samanadhikaranam we saw. Then there is Visheshana Vishesha Bhava. Yeah, I just wanted to make a clarification. I had mentioned a sentence, you know, as an example. For Samanadhikaranyam, the same Vibhakti and Vachana is not needed. For that we saw an example of, I think, Ayodhya Patihi Ramaha, Tasya Patni Sita. There Tasya Pada is in Shashti Ekvachana, whereas Ayodhyapatihi and Ramaha, these are in Prathama Ekvachana. Their Samanadhikaranyam is not only between, in between the first two words, which are in Prathama, but also Tasya. Adhikarana is same. However, the definition of Samanadhikaranyam includes the same Vibhakti. The reason is, when I use a sentence such as Ayodhyapatihi Ramaha, Tasya Patni Sita, there Ekatinga Vakyam, if you look at that, then Asti has to be supplied before Tasya. Or you have to say Yaha Ayodhya Patihi Ramaha Asti Bhavati Tasya Patni Sita Bhavati. So they are split into two sentences. And when you are analyzing each individual sentence, there you look at the same Vibhakti. So just as an aside, otherwise both have the same adhikarana by yogika vyutpatti or the samasa vigraha of samana adhikarana, samana adhikaranya, and then tasya bhava samana adhikaranya. We saw that by that technical derivation, tasya has the same adhikarana as Ramaha or Ayodhyapatihi. Anyway, here tat and tvam are in Samanadhikaranyam, so they have Samanadhikaranyam as Sambandha. Then Visheshana Vishesha Bhava we saw as Tat takes away the individuality of Tvam and Tvam takes away the Upadhis of Tat, thereby Vyavartakattvam is there, and which leads to Visheshana Vishesha Bhava between the Padas. The third Sambandha is Pratyagatma and Paramatma have Lakshana Laksha Laksha Bhava, Lakshana Laksha Bhava, where we use Bhagatyaga Lakshana then. So third point we have to look at, third Sambandha is Lakshana Laksha Bhava Sambandha. Yatha असाधारण धर्म प्रतिपादकं वाक्यं लक्षणं तादृश वाक्य प्रतिपाद्य लक्ष्यम्। सो असाधारण धर्म प्रतिपादकं वाक्यं लक्षणं। व्हाट इज असाधारण धर्म? इन द डेफिनेशन व्हेन यू डिफाइन समथिंग, से फॉर एग्जांपल sugar is that which is sweet, it should necessarily mean as a corollary that wherever you see sweetness, whether or not you see sugar, there is sweetness. See as in wherever you taste sweetness, whether or not you see sugar, there is sugar. That is asadharana dharma of sugar. The madhuryam of sharkaram is the असाधारण धर्म ऑफ शार्कर। तादृश वाक्य प्रतिपाद्य लक्ष्यम एंड दैट काइंड ऑफ अ सेंटेंस, डिफाइनिंग सेंटेंस, व्हाट इट रिवील्स इज द लक्ष्य, द डिफाइंड। आई मीन जस्ट टू यूज द वर्ड लक्षण मीनिंग द डेफिनेशन, हाउएवर हियर लक्षण इज द इम्प्लाइड मीनिंग ऑल्सो। सह एव अयम देवदत्त इति वाक्ये सह अयम इति शब्दद्वय बोध्य विरुद्ध धर्म भूत तद्देश काल एंड एतद्देश कालादि वैशिष्ट्य परित्यागेन देवदत्तत्व विशिष्ट देवदत्त पिंड मात्रेण सह सह एव अयम देवदत्त इति वाक्यस्य लक्ष्य लक्षण भाव संबंध सिद्ध्यति। सो इन दी सह सोयम देवदत्त, here it is taken as saha eva ayam devadatta. In that sentence saha and ayam have virodha because both the words stand for different place and time, but you have to give those contradictory attributes, then the devadatta, devadattatva vishishta, devadatta, whatever you call as devadatta, devadattatva vishishta devadatta पिंड मात्रेण सह। सो द पिंड, द शरीर विच इज देयर, विच यू कॉल एज देवदत्त, नाउ लुकिंग एट अयम देवदत्त दैट पार्ट ऑफ द सेंटेंस, देयर सह एव अयम देवदत्त इति वाक्यस्य लक्ष्य लक्षण भाव संबंध सिद्ध्यति। यू हैव गिवन अप द भाग ऑफ व्हाट इज कॉन्ट्राडिक्टरी, तद्देश तत्काल एंड एतद्देश एतत्काल, यू हैव रिजेक्टेड, what remains is common and that is the lakshya, there is a lakshya lakshana bhava. evam eva tattvamasi iti vakyapi tattvam iti padadvaya bodhya viruddha dharma bhuta parokshatva aparokshatva vaishishtya parityagena chaitanya matrena sah tattvamasi iti vakyase lakshya lakshana bhava sambandha siddhyati. we have seen this similarly, it is extended to the exemplified tattvamasi mahavakya. There is a lakshana lakshya bhava between tat and tvam. Why? Because you give up the contradictory attributes and chaitanya matrena saha tattvamasi iti vakyasya lakshya lakshana bhavaha. The lakshana is there in the tattvamasi vakya and chaitanya matra is the lakshya. Therefore there is lakshana lakshya bhava. तस्मात् विरुद्धांश परित्यागेन अविरुद्ध चैतन्यांश मात्र बोधकम् तत्त्वमसि इति वाक्यं लक्षणम्। द वाक्य इज लक्षण। सो दिस इज व्हाट आई वाज मेंशनिंग व्हेन द थ्री संबंधा हैव बीन शोन इन द शोन टू बी देयर इन द तत्त्वमसि महावाक्य, बिटवीन व्हाट एंड व्हाट देयर इज अ संबंध इज नॉट रियली सो क्लियर, ऑल्दो इट इज सेड पदयोः, स्टिल there is a vakya and lakshya where there is lakshana lakshya lakshya sambandha or lakshya lakshana bhava sambandha. tasmat viruddhamsha parityagena aviruddha chaitanyamsha matra bodhakam tattvamasi iti vakyam lakshanam. the mahavakya is lakshanam and akhanda chaitanyam lakshyam iti siddham. what is the implied meaning? that is lakshya, which is the akhanda chaitanya there. tattvamasi iti vakyam upadesha vakyam. now there is a differentiation made, although all four are mahavakyas and they are not limited to four, there are many mahavakyas in Upanishads, still these four are picked from each of the four Vedas. They have the same purpose of revealing the Aikya between Jiva and Brahma. Now, what is the difference between the four in terms of revelation of Aikya? There is no difference, but still there is some kind of a progression which can be seen. Tattvam asi iti vakyam upadesha vakyam. This is the upadesha vakyam as taught by the guru to the shishya, as in Chandogya 6th chapter, Shweta Ketu is taught multiple times, 9 times, Tattvamasi. So there, it is an upadesha given to Shweta Ketu. It is an upadesha vakya, mahavakya. Prajnanam Brahma iti vakyam swarupa bodhaka vakyam. What is the swarupa of Brahma? Tattvamasi, there tat is Ishvara. Tvam is you, Shweta Ketu, or anybody in the place of Shweta Ketu as a with a Shishya Bhava, Jiva. With Bhagatyaga Lakshana, you land on Shuddha Chaitanya. However, when you are taught Tattvamasi, the Mahavakya is Upadesha Vakya. Prajnanam Brahma is what reveals the nature of the Brahma Padartha. What is it? It is Prajnanam. And yesterday, we saw Prajnanam Anandam Brahma. It is Ananda Rupa. Then Ayam Atma Brahma iti aparokshatva bodhakam vakyam. Each Mahavakya will lead to the same goal. However, if you analyze all the four, you can take all the four and analyze and see how I can see the progression. When Tattvamasi is taught and it is followed by Prajnanam Brahma, the very Swarupa of Brahma, then Ayam Atma Brahma, Ayam being Idam Shabda in Pullinga, Ayam Atma Brahma iti aparokshatva bodhakam vakyam. This that I find myself to be is Brahma. So there is aparokshatvam there. And then that leads to Sakshatkara or Anubhava as what? Aham Brahma Asmi. You put together everything that you have learned so far and then you land on Aham Brahma Asmi. Iti Anubhava Bodhaka Vakyam. This is the Anubhava of a Jnani, Aham Brahma, not Aham Jnani. Not as Jivo Brahma Vanapara, that Jiva is I. Therefore, Aham Brahma Asmi is the final landing. So there are some verses, I'll just go through them. Yene kshate shrunoti idam jigrati vyakaroti cha svadvasadu vijanati tat prajnanam udahrutam. What is prajnanam? Prajnana is that through which, yena ikshate. Idam yena ikshate, idam yena shrunoti, idam yena jigrati ityadi. Vyakaroti cha. So, Asti Bhati. Not only it is there, but you know through whichever entity that which manifests itself and makes it possible to know, that is Prajnana. Swadu Aswadu Vijanati. One knows. So basically it is everything, in the form of everything and also available for bhana. Thereby, it is prajnana. Otherwise, in Keno Upanishad, it is said as pratibodha viditam. That Brahma is pratibodha viditam. In each and every cognition, through which you know, that is prajnana. Or that which is present as aham in each and every vritti, that is prajnana. Chaturmukhadi deveshu manushyashva gavadishu chaitanyamekam brahmatah prajnanam brahma mayyapi. In me also the same prajnana is there. which is there in each and every being starting from Brahma. Whether it is in Manushya or Ashva or Gavadi, whether it is in Gau, it is the same Brahma Tattva. That Chaitanya is one without a second, and it is in me also. First in me also, and Swarupatah. Paripurna Paratmasmin Dehe Vidyadikarini Buddhe Sakshitaya Stitva Spuranahamiti Riyate. Then that Chaitanya is there in me. It is Paripurna. It is Brahma, therefore Paratma, and Asmin Dehe Vidyadikarini, one who is a Adhikari of Jnana. In that Adhikari, as a Buddhi Sakshi, it is there. Aham Aham Iti Spurati. So Spuran Aham Iti Iriyate. Being as a Sakshi. Not as I am this body or I am associated with any sense organ, but as a Sakshi to everything. Even of that Ahankara, it is a Sakshi. Buddhe Sakshi. Satah Purnam Paratmatra Brahma Shabdena Varnitaha Asmityaikya Paramarshastena Brahma Bhavamyaham. So I am that Brahma. Why so? Because Swatah Purnaha Brihi Vriddho, that Brahma which is Swatah Purna and Paratma, that is the meaning of Brahma Shabda. And it is said Asmi. Aham Brahma Asmi, therefore Asmi Iti Aikya Paramarsha. There is this Sakshatkara of Brahma, which is Purna, Paramatma, as I, Aham. Therefore, Tena Karanena Tena Hetuna, Aham Brahma Bhavami, I am that Brahma. Ekameva Dvitiyam San Nama Rupa Vivarjitam Srishtev Puradunapyasya Tadruktam Taditiryate. That Ekamevadvitiya Brahma, which I am now, is bereft of Nama Rupa. Dehadi cannot be there in that Brahma. Tadatme Sambandha is Mithya Sambandha. That Brahma which does not have Nama Rupa, when Srishtev Pura, even before the Srishti was created, Brahma was there. Brahma has always been there. Satchidananda Tattva has always been there. But before creation, there was no Nama Rupa. After creation, what is it? It is manifestation of Nama Rupa. But even then, Adhunapi Asya Tadruktvam Taditi Iriyate. What is that Brahma even now? Even now it is Nama Rupa Vivarjitam. Just because there is creation, sustenance, and we find ourselves in this samsara, does not mean that we have lost the prior status before the Srishti. And we can take it as before I came into association with this Srishti. Whatever was my Swarupa, it continues to be so. It is still Nama Rupa Vivarjitam. Shrotur Dehendriyatitam Vastvatra Tvam Padheritam Ekata Grahyate Siti Tadaikyam Anubhuyatam. Therefore, Nama Rupa Varjita Brahma, which I am, Shrotuhu Dehendriyatitam. I who am listening this Mahavakya am beyond Deha Indriya. Cannot have any Sambandha there because I am Asanga. So that Vastu Atra Tvampada Iritam, that same Vastu is revealed by Tvampada also. Through Ekata. Ekata Grahyate. How asi iti tattvam asi isi, asi is there. Thereby, aikyam anubhuyatam, one should by this jnana itself have anubhava of aikya with Brahma. Aikya being not oneness which is going to be fructified, but oneness which is revealed as always being there. There was never a second. Svaprakasha parokshattvam ayam ityuktito matam ahankarad dehantat pratyagatmeti giyate. The same entity is called as pratyagatma. Why? Because ahankaradi dehanta, ending with deha, outward, starting with ahankara, vijnanamaya kosha, where anandamaya kosha is assumed, the individuality which cannot be felt in anandamaya kosha, in shushupti, comes alive in swapna and jagrat avasthas, whereby vijnanamaya kosha helps us that there has already been an anandamaya kosha, sambandha which is ajnana sambandha, karana. Only from the karya drishti karana can be analyzed. You cannot be in karana avastha and analyze anything. Therefore, ahankara adi has been mentioned. That ahankara is there in the subtle form or in bija avastha, in shushupti avastha also, in anandamaya kosha also. So, svaprakasha aparokshattvam. Svaprakasha aparokshattvam ayam ityuktito matam. Ayam atma. There ayam is aparoksha to me. Although ayam can mean someone else, but it is the closest. If you go any closer, it will become aham. Therefore, the closest to aham is ayam. Whoever is Uttama Purusha, to him, whenever he is speaking about something, the closest is that idam shabda, where the ayam is the form in masculine, ayam atma. Ahankara dehantat pratyagatma iti giyate. And in comparison to ahankara, deha is the most outward. Therefore, deha cannot be ayam. So, you start with deha, you see there is something within. So, you use a closer pronoun. So, deha is dropped. Then, through panchakosha viveka also, you drop the annamaya kosha. You go within as atma. So, I am atma brahma. Which is that? I am brahma. Who am that? I. Not the annamaya kosha. Because annamaya atma becomes annamaya kosha. Then atma is something which is within. And that atma is pranamaya kosha. Then here you see ahankara dehantat. It indicates panchakosha also. Then you land on. Finally, we will land on one free from ahankar also. That is also taken away from the definition of atma. So ayam is not applicable even to ahankara. It is closer than aham, ayam. Closer than ayam, which was ahankara in the final analysis. Then you say this ahankara is also not ayam. So you take away ayam from ahankara and then land on pratyagatma. So pratyagatma iti giyate. Compared to the others, deha, prana ityadi and ahankara also, I am further within. That is indicated by ayam and that is aparoksha to me. You cannot analyze anything further. After you drop ahankara sambandha. Ahankara is needed, buddhi is needed for any analysis. In that analysis, holding on to the ahankara, you analyze that you cannot be anandamaya kosha also. Anandamaya is kosha, it is not atma. Thereby, aparoksha pratyagatma is meant by ayam. Drishyamanasya sarvasya jagatas tattvam iriyate brahma shabdena tad brahma svaprakashatma rupakam. Then what is this Brahma, which I am? Drishyamanasya sarvasya. Just give me a moment. Sorry. So, drishyamanasya sarvasya jagataha. The entire prapancha jagat which is seen. Drishyamana. तत्त्वम् ईर्यते ब्रह्मशब्देन तद्ब्रह्म स्वप्रकाशात्म रूपकम्। इन रियालिटी जगत इज नॉट देर, सो सर्वम खलविदं ब्रह्म। इफ यू हियर दैट सर्वम इजंट देर, बाद सामानाधिकरण्यम, ओनली ब्रह्म इज देर विच इज आई। सो ब्रह्म शब्देन तद् ब्रह्म, दैट ब्रह्म इटसेल्फ अपीयर्स एज दिस प्रपंच, नाम रूप हैज नो presence per se, and then there are these sentences talking about which Veda and Sangraha Shloka which has been made by creator iti granthakrut ayam, so granthakrut has made this, granthakara has made these shlokas on his own, swakiye ashtavi shloke chaturnavi vedana mahavakyartham sanjagraha, so across the Vedas mahavakyas have been summed up in श्लोकास बाय दी ग्रंथकार। वी लुक्ड एट दी मूल ऑल दी फोर महावाक्यास एंड देन बियॉन्ड दी महावाक्यास यू हैव टू एक्सटेंड दिस टू सत्यम ज्ञानम अवांतर वाक्य आल्सो सत्यम ज्ञानम अनंतम। सो यथा महावाक्यास्त पदानाम भागत्याग लक्षण तथा वाक्यांतरेष्वपि सत्यम ज्ञानम अनंतम इत्यादि पदानि भागत्याग लक्षणया एव शुद्धं ब्रह्म बोधयन्ति परोक्षतया नॉट अपरोक्षतया। व्हेन यू हियर दी लक्षण वाक्य सत्यम ज्ञानम अनंतम ब्रह्म, देयर सत्यम ज्ञानम अनंतम, देयर लक्षणास ऑफ ब्रह्म, इट इज एन अवांतर वाक्य। सो वाक्यांतर अवांतर वाक्य not considered as mahavakya because here there is no aham, aikya is not revealed. What you can infer though is wherever there is satya, meaning satta is there, that is brahma satta. If at all one can analyze and understand or has studied earlier in earlier janma and can gather that I am existent, this much I know for sure, then I am Brahma. How? Satyam Brahma. By definition, Satyam Brahma. If I am Satya, then I have to be Brahma. Otherwise, the Lakshana makes no sense. If you define something and then someone else, Asadharana Dharma should be there in Lakshana there. It cannot be Sadharana Dharma. The Satta which is Sadharana to everything, that Satta does not belong to any of those things. It belongs to Brahma. Jnanam is Chaitanya Chid. Anantam, we already know, and anyway, Ananta does not really need a definition, does not have an Anta. Antaha na vidyate asya brahmana tad brahma anantam brahma iti ityadi padani bhagatyaga lakshanaya eva shuddham brahma bodhayanti. So, whenever you look at this sentence also, you have to do bhagatyaga lakshana, whatever is asat, you have to drop. You have to land on by Shakti. There is no direct meaning there, which if you say Satyam, it is Vachyartha of Satya is not the meaning of Brahma. What does Satya do really? Satya is there, it takes away Asad Rupa Brahma. Takes Asad Rupa as a possibility of Brahma. Jagat Karana Brahma has been mentioned. It cannot be Asat. Jnanam takes away Jadatva. By saying Chaitanya Chidrupa, it takes away Jadatva. Ananta takes away the Antavattvam. Thereby, Satyam Jnanam Anantam also, by the very meaning of the words, do not stand for Brahma. The Shakyartha is not the meaning of Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma. The Shabda Bodha is the Vakya Bodha. The entire sentence, when you understand, it is only through Lakshana. Shuddham Brahma Bodhayanti Natu Shaktya. Nahi Kasya Chiddhapi Padasya Shuddham Brahma Vachyam Bhavati Iti Siddhantaha. The Shuddha Brahma is not the meaning of, not only Satyam Jnanam Ananta, it is not the meaning of Pada, Shuddha Pada also or Brahma Pada also. Although it is called as Brahma or Omkara. None of these words, including the word Nirguna Brahma also, is not the real meaning of Brahma Why? Because nama rupa is mithya. Kasya chidapi padasya shuddham brahma vachyam na bhavati. This is the siddhanta. You have to drop all name and forms. What you remain, you are. There is no need to qualify it with a name. The name is only for vyavahara. Yato vacho nivartante apraapya manasasah naiva vachana manasa praptum shakyo na chakshusha athat adesho neti neti ityadi shrutibhyah. There are many shrutis that take away the vachyartha for Brahma, including the Brahma shabda itself. So vachah yatah nivartante, yatah yasmad brahmanah vachah nivartante. The vak comes back without objectifying. Therefore, the word cannot lead to the meaning as it is. Only through lakshana it can mean Brahma, Shuddha Brahma. Along with the manas, therefore, it is not an object of meditation. You cannot imagine anything and say this is Brahma also. Whether as taught by Shruti or not, it is only an indirection. It will help you take away your misconception. So the final prakriya, since it is not available to vak, not to manas, therefore, and through chakshur indriya itya, indriya grahya, it isn't. Therefore, what is the adesha? Atha, ataha. Therefore, since Brahma is not the vachyartha, therefore, what is the real prakriya, adesha, teaching? The real teaching, including in the Mahavakya, is neti neti. Na iti, na iti. If you say na, what is na? If you say na karyam, then obvious conclusion can be karanam. Then you have to use the next na also. Na karanam api. In satyam also, if you say satyam, then if there is a thinking of asat, then na asat, therefore satyam, no, not even satya, meaning vachyartha. As it is not to say that it is sat, it is to take away the meaning of asat. So jadatva, if you take away, you land on chaitanya. However, the word Chaitanya by itself is not the meaning of Shuddha Brahma. Or rather, you look at Jnana also. If you see the Bhashya in Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, you will see there is a long discussion. Each and every connotation of the word is taken away. So it is a neti neti prakriya used in Bhashya itself. You use an indirection so that you don't conclude with the vachyartha, you don't stop there. So you use an implied meaning and then you land on that. You drop all that you have used as tools. What is understood, you hold on to that. Everything else has to be dropped. The words have to be dropped. That is the idea. Athata, adeshu neti neti, ityadi shrutibhya. These are the pramanas for that. Tasmat sarvanyapi padani vishishtasya vachakani shuddhasya lakshakani cha bhavanti. Therefore, all padas in Shruti are vachaka of the Vishishta, but Shuddha Brahma they cannot stand for with Shakyartha. You have to use Lakshana. Therefore, Lakshakani cha bhavanti. There is a Laksha Lakshaka, Laksha Bhava Sambandha, Lakshana Laksha Bhava. So, Lakshaka or Lakshana, and thereby Lakshya is Shuddha Brahma. Ayam Atma Brahma, in the Tippana, Ayam Atma Brahma, Idam Atharva Vediya Mandukya Upanishad Gatam Mahavakyam. So Mandukya Upanishad has this mantra, Ayam Atma Brahma. Then that Brahma Chatushpat. So Ayam Atma Brahma. Prapanchastu bhashyadau panchadashya mahavakya viveka prakaranecha drashtavyaha. So prapancha, this is a tippan on what now? I am not seeing that. Okay. Yes. So I am Atma Brahma. So on these, each of these where these occur have been mentioned in the Tippana. Aparoksham Dvidham. There is Aparoksha when it was said as where is the second? Here, Nitya Aparokshataya, Bhasamana Atmaya. So, Aham Aham. When you say I am, Brahmadi Stambha Stambhanta Sarva Praninam Aham Aham Iti, Nitya Aparokshataya, Bhasamana Atmaya Brahma Iti Vakyartha of I am Atma Brahma. There, Aparokshatvam. On Aparokshatvam, there is a Tippana which says Aparoksham Dvidham. Aparoksha is of two types. Adhyam Swayam Prakasha Swarupatvad Buddhi Vritti Prakashaka Sakshi Swarupa Atma Eva Aparoksha Ityuchyate. Atma is called as Aparoksha. Dvitiyam Aham Swaprakasha Atma Asmi Iti Buddhi Vritti Rupam Yat Jnanam Tad Aparoksham Ityuchyate. So Sakshat Aparokshat, there is a mantra, Sakshat Aparokshat. That Sakshat Brahma, Aparoksha Brahma. There Aparokshat is Aparoksha. Known as oneself, Sakshat, without anything intervening, that is Aparoksha. That is Brahma, that is Atma. Then second Aparokshatvam is, in the Vritti you understand this, Sakshi Bhava. Aham Swaprakasha Atma Asmi. I am that Aparokshas Atma Swaprakasha who does not depend on any other Prakasha Chaitanya. Iti Buddhi Vritti Rupam Yat Jnanam. That Vritti Rupa Jnana is also called as Aparoksha Jnana. That is the second type of aparoksha. Tatra adhyam aparoksham atma swarupatvina sada vidyamanatvat nityam. Dvitiyam tu anityam buddhi vrittehe kadachitkatvat. So, vritti cannot stay for ever. Whenever there is something else, whether any sense organ is grasping and feeding you some data or you are thinking about something else, another vritti will come up. Therefore, the aparoksha vritti will go away. However, the atma which is aparoksha will ever be aparoksha, was aparoksha, is aparoksha, will be aparoksha. However, vritti rupa aparokshatvam is anitya because vritti is anitya. Whereas, atma swarupa adhya aparokshatvam is nitya. Then Aham Brahmasmi Idam Shukla Yajurvediya Brihadaranyaka Upanishad Gatam Mahavakyam. Aham Brahmasmi occurs in Brihadaranyaka. Prajnanam Brahma Idam Rigvediya Aitareya Upanishad Mahavakyam. Upanishad Gatam Mahavakyam. So Aitareya Upanishad in Rigveda has this mantra Prajnanam Brahma. Back to Mula. Maya Yaha Apekshikam Satyattvam Chaitanyasya Nirapeksham Satyattvam Cha Iti Ubhayam Militva Satya Shabdasya Vachyam Bhavati. Why can't Satya Shabda lead to Shuddha Brahma as Vachyartha? Because Maya has Apekshika Satyattvam. Compared to others, Maya being Karana, Upadana Karana will exist longer than the Karya Prapancha. Therefore, Satyattvam, when you say Satya, what is Satya? That Karana Ishvara is Satya. Prapancha is not Satya. There, Chaitanya has Maya along with it as Jagat Karana. So, Nirapeksham Satyattvam Chaitanyasya and Apekshika Satyattvam Mayayaha. Iti Ubhayam Militva Satya Shabdasya Vachyam Bhavati. When you say Satya, Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma and then Tasmad Vaye Tasmad Atmanaha Akasha Sambhutaha. Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma and then from that Brahma, if Akasha has come about, then it is Karana. If it is Karana, then Maya should be there. Nirguna Brahma cannot be Karana of anything. Therefore, Maya is there in the Lakshana, hidden in the Lakshana. निरपेक्ष मुख्य सत्यत्वं लक्ष्यं भवति बुद्धिवृत्ति रूपं ज्ञानं स्वयं प्रकाश रूपं ज्ञानं च इति उभयं मिलित्वा ज्ञान शब्दस्य वाच्यं भवति. सो इन द अर्लियर केस यू हैव टू यूज लक्षण टू लैंड ऑन निरपेक्ष सत्यत्वं ऑफ चैतन्य निर्गुण ब्रह्म विदाउट द आपेक्ष सत्यत्वं बीइंग मिक्स्ड. In the case of Jnana Shabda, why can't Jnana Shabda by itself be talking about Shuddha Brahma, Vachyartha? Because Buddhi Vritti Rupam Jnanam, Swayam Prakash Rupam Jnanam Chaiti Uhayam Militva Jnana Shabdasya Vachyam Bhavati. When you say Jnana, what Jnana? Jnana does not by itself mean Chaitanya directly. What does it mean? It means Vritti Rupa Jnana. So Jnana is usually translated as knowledge. By implied meaning you land on consciousness. That Chaitanya, although in Vritti there is Chetana, there is a mix-up of Jada Vritti. Thereby Jnana Shabda has, Vritti Rupa Jnana has Jadatva mixed in there. Swayam Prakashamshastu Lakshya Uchyate. Whereas you have to use Lakshana and land on the Swayam Prakasha without the Vritti Jada Rupa mix up. So Lakshana is used there as well. Vishaya Sambandha Janya Sukhakara Sattvika Antakkarana Vritti Parama Premas Padaswarupam Sukham Chaiti Uvayam Militva Ananda Padasya Vachyam. When you say Ananda, one considers it as the experiential Ananda, which is Vishaya Sambandha Janya. So Vishaya Ananda is Vishaya Sambandha Janya Sukhakara Vritti. That Sukhakara Vritti is Ananda, which has gradation Priya Moda Pramoda. So Sattvika Antakkarana Vritti, it is Sattvika alright, because Sukha cannot be there if Sattva isn't there. When the desire drops, then the Rajasika Tamasika Vrittis or mix up Gunas drop, and Sattvika Amsha remains. Thereby, Sukha Bhoga is there. Parama Premas Padaswarupam Sukham Chaiti Ubhayam Militva. However, whenever the desire goes away due to Prapti of the Vishaya, that time there is a Sukhakara Vritti. However, what one is hankering after is one's own Swarupananda. So, Parama Premas Padaswarupam, which is at the root of each and every desire, is the prema towards one's real self. That is the Lakshartha there. So, iti ubhayam militva ananda padasya vachyam, vrityamusham vihaya, you drop the sukhakara vrityamusha and swarupananda amusha you hold on to, that is bhagatyaga lakshana. And then you land on Lakshartha. Ittham sarvapadanam shuddhe brahmani lakshana iti sangshepa sharirake pratipaditam. This has been explained in sangshepa sharirake, which is, sangshepa is in comparison to the Brahma Sutras. Sharirake is based on sharirake sutras, Brahma Sutras. So sangshepa sharirake kara talks about this lakshana, how to use it in the case of avantara vakyas also. Purvoktartha sangraha. So what is the conclusion here? Gangayam ghosha ityatra jahal lakshana. Shono dhavati itti ityatra ajahal lakshana. Soyam devadatta ityatra bhagatyaga lakshana. So to sum up, there are three lakshanas. Shakyartha is not revealing anything meaningful. So in Mahavakyas you have to apply Lakshana. Which Lakshana? Out of these three, Tattvamasi ityadi Mahavakyeshu Jahal Lakshana va Ajahal Lakshana va na yujyate ataha te parityajya bhagatyaga lakshana eva pradarshita. Since the earlier two are not applicable, you have to use bhagatyaga lakshana or Jahad Ajahal Lakshana. Ataha यतो वाचो निवर्तन्ते इत्यादि श्रुतयः ब्रह्मण कस्यापि पदस्य वाच्यं भवेत् इति बोधयन्ति. Why cannot it be somehow interpreted directly? Meaning, why cannot सत्यम ज्ञानम अनंतम ब्रह्म और तत्वमसी, एनी ऑफ दीज सेंटेंसेस बी टेकन लिटरली, मीनिंग विथ वाच्यार्थ शक्यार्थ, बिकॉज यतो वाचो निवर्तन्ते सेज दैट यू कैनॉट हैव द शुद्ध ब्रह्म एज द मीनिंग डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम एनी वर्ड, देयर बाय दैट इज द प्रमाण विच टेल्स यू दैट यू हैव टू यूज लक्षण इत्यादि श्रुतया ब्रह्मण कस्यापि पदस्य वाच्यं भवेति बोधयन्ति, अतः समस्त पदेषु ब्रह्म विषये लक्षणा एव लक्षणया लक्षणा एव इत्थं ग्राह्य, सो यू हैव टू यूज लक्षण। मायायाः अपेक्षकं सत्त्वं चैतन्यनिष्ठं निरपेक्षं पारमार्थिकं सत्त्वं च मिलित्वा सत्यपदवाच्यमुच्यते, तत्र निरपेक्षसत्त्वम् एव सत्यपदस्य लक्ष्यम्। इवन इन द केस ऑफ अवांतर वाक्य लक्षण वाक्य आल्सो यू हैव टू यूज लक्षण भाग त्याग लक्षण वेर सत्य, वी जस्ट सॉ सो आई विल नॉट रिपीट इट, सत्य हैज माया आपेक्षिक सत्त एंड माया आपेक्षिक सत्त एंड द रियल सत्त मिक्स्ड अप, देयर यू हैव टू ड्रॉप द आपेक्षिक सत्त एंड निरपेक्ष सत्त यू हैव टू होल्ड ऑन टू। स्वयं प्रकाशमानं ज्ञानं बुद्धिवृत्ति रूप ज्ञानं च मिलित्वा ज्ञानपदवाच्यं भवति, तत्र स्वयं प्रकाश ज्ञानं ज्ञानपदस्य लक्ष्यम्। So you use the aumsha which is swayam prakasha in jnana, whereas vritti rupa jnana you drop off. Bhagatyalakshana. Atmana swarupanandha ishta vishaya sambandha janya sukhakara sattvikantakrana vritti rupam vishaya sukancha militva ananda padam vachyam bhavati. Ananda or ananta, when it is mentioned, then that ananda has a mix of gradations of sukhas which have to be dropped and you land on lakshya swarupananda through bhagatyaga lakshana. Tatra vritti rupam visheshukam parityajya swatma swarupa sukham eva ananda pada laksham. Mahavakyeshu padadvayapi lakshana angikaro nishphala ityakshepaha. So there is an akshepa, why do you use lakshana in both the padas? You can do with one. Use lakshana in one. So in Mahavakya, you don't need to use lakshana for both padas. This is an aropa, you don't get any additional benefit. Atra kechid ahuhu. Mahavakyeshu virodha pariharaya. Mahavakyeshu virodha pariharaya. Padadvayapi lakshana angikaro vyartha. You don't need to use lakshartha on both padas. Why? There is no additional benefit. Eka pade lakshana angikaraneva virodha nivrutte riti. Teshamayam ashya. What is the idea there? Sarvajnyatvadi dharma vishishtasya kinchijnyatvadi dharma vishishtena saha aikyam yadyapi na yujyate. Tathapi eka pada laksharta bhuta shuddhasya padantararta bhuta vishishtena aikyam yujyata eva. So although the sarvajnyatva and alpajnyatva, sarvashaktimatva and alpashaktimatva are contradictory, therefore aikya is not possible, you use lakshana on one. He says, some of the people say that ekapada laksharta bhuta shuddha. There is a shuddha laksha in one pada. It is there in both, but you use in one pada, he says. एक पद लक्ष्यार्थ भूत शुद्धस्य पदांतरार्थ भूत विशिष्टेन ऐक्यम युज्यते एव। However, you can use lakshana on one, land on chaitanya and equate that with the padantara artha, the artha of the other word where you have not used lakshana. In there is a vishishta. In with that there is a aikya possible. So drishtanta is given to explain what the purvapakshi means here. Tatra drishtanta kshatriya manushyoyam brahmanah. So kshatriya manushyah ayam brahmana. This brahmana is a kshatriya purushah manushyah. If that is a statement, it is contradictory. How can a kshatriya manushya be brahmana? Ityatra kshatriyatva dharma vishishtasya brahmanatva dharma vishishtena sa aikyam viruddham eva. So as it is, the sentence makes no sense. Manushyoyam brahmanah. There is another visheshana there, manushyah. Kshatriyatvam and brahmanatvam have virodha. But manushyatvam has no virodha with brahmanatvam or kshatriyatvam. So this kshatriya is a manushya, that brahmana is a manushya, or rather I am brahmana. So if you say this kshatriya is a manushya, this brahmana is also manushya, what is the problem there? What is the lakshana? You use lakshana on kshatriya manushya, because it is a samasa here. You say manushyatvam is the lakshana. Through lakshana you land on manushyatvam. मनुष्यं ब्राह्मण इत्यत्र तु क्षत्रियत्व धर्म रहित शुद्ध मनुष्यस्य ब्राह्मणत्व धर्म विशिष्टेन सह ऐक्येन विरोधः. वन्स यू लैंड ऑन थ्रू लक्षण ऑन क्षत्रिय मनुष्य एज वन पद इन ब्राह्मण यू डोंट हैव टू डू लक्षण एंड लैंड ऑन मनुष्य. वाय क्षत्रिय मनुष्य इज अ मनुष्य बाय लक्षण मनुष्य. Not necessarily kshatriya, can be brahmana also. Their equation is valid. Ayam manushya brahmana. Ayam brahmana manushya works both ways. What is the problem there? No problem. Similarly here, aikya virodha can be taken away in the exemplar. Tatha kinchidnyatvadi dharma vishishta chaitanyasya sarvajnyatvadi dharma vishishta chaitanyasya chaikyam na yujyate virodhat apitu jiveshvara vachaka padayoho चैतन्य मात्र रक्षकत्वे संभवत्यपि अन्यतर पदस्येव चैतन्य मात्र लक्षणायाम सत्याम तस्य लक्ष्यस्य चैतन्य मात्रस्य पदांतर वाच्यार्थ भूत सर्वज्ञत्वादि धर्म विशिष्टेन वा किंचिज्ञत्वादि धर्म विशिष्टेन वा एकत्वे विरोधः न भवेदेव. नाउ वंस यू लैंड ऑन वाच्यार्थ नॉट बीइंग मीनिंगफुल एंड यू हैव टू यूज लक्षण जीवेश्वर वाचक पदयो हो दी पदास वेर वाचकास हैव विरोध. सो वाच्यार्थास हैव विरोध जीव एंड ईश्वर हैव विरोध. हाउएवर दोस वाचक पदा जीव एंड ईश्वर दे हैव चैतन्य मात्र लक्षकत्वे संभवत्यपि अन्यतर पदस्येव. यू टेक जीव और ईश्वर यू ड्रॉप दी किंचिज्ञत्व और सर्वज्ञत्व based on which pada you are dropping the vachyartha holding on to lakshya. Then chaitanya matra will remain. Chaitanya matre lakshanayam satyam tasya lakshyasya chaitanya matrasya. That chaitanya rupa brahma shuddha brahma which remains padantara vachyartha bhuta sarvajnyatvadi dharma vishishtena va kinchijnyatvadi dharma vishishtena va ekatve virodha na bhave. Then you can say as if in jiva if you landed on chaitanya shabda by using it on tvam, so that tvam is not jiva anymore, chaitanya, then ishvara is chaitanya. That is the statement. On the other hand, if you use lakshya, lakshyartha on tatpada, then you have tvam chaitanyam, you are chaitanya. No contradiction there. Jiva is chaitanya. Jiva is a chetana vastu. Ishvara tatpada is a chetana vastu. Jiva tvampada is a chetana vastu. There is no contradiction at all. Virodha ekatve virodha na bhave deva tasmat padadvaye lakshana abhyupagame na kachidapi yuktirastiti. So the Purvapakshi says with one you can do, why do you need two? We'll see the answer to that in the next part. सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपं अधिष्ठानं बुद्धे बोध्यं बुद्धेर दुःखत्वेन अपारं सर्ववेदान्त वेद्यं प्रत्येक परम तदेवाहं मुक्तो नीति मे निश्चितामिति. सॉरी आई हैड सम थ्रोट इरिटेशन. सॉरी फॉर दैट इरिटेशन इन साउंड. नमस्ते.